Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear friends. This is my second video about ring program. I have already introduced the ring program, how to download, how to install it in my first lesson about ring program. In this lesson, we are going to learn almost all of the basics of ring programs. That is how to write the conditional statements, functions, loopings, while loop, for loop, do again loop, etc. Okay, this is the ring notepad you are watching on the screen. This is the output window. I have separated this output window from this main. You can embed it here. Just drag it here and it will be embedded. Or you can just drag out of this main window. This is the main script window. You can write your scripts here. But before you write your scripts here, you need to save this scripting file with the .ring extension. But before going to start our second lesson, I just want to show you the examples file that have been placed in applications folder. So for example, this is the analog clock. Just double click this and then run. Your analog clock is ready. The second one is the calculator. Double click this and run. Your calculator is ready. Let me show you some more things like this thing and run it. Yes, these are cubes spinning. So these were the programs that were coded in ring program. Now let's open a file in which we have already written C hello world and click this and it will run and the output will be printed to this output window. So let's start our lesson. So the first topic is how to print on the screen. Ring program is very flexible. You can use several functions for the same thing. For example, you can use C command for printing hello world on the screen. You can also use put instead of C. You can also use print command as you use in Python or R programming or some other program. But for using print command, you must load stdlib.ring before using this print command because print command is stored in this file. So let's try. Instead of C, we type put here and change this to just hello and then click this. It will print out on the screen just hello. Let's use print. Print. For print, you must enclose this in parentheses and then click this. You will see an error because we have not loaded that stdlib. So load stdlib.ring and now run this command. You will see hello on the screen. Similar is the case with input. You can use different commands for getting input from the keyboard. So there are four methods of getting input. You can use give and then you can write the variable name. Anything you can write here. Get my name. Any variable. A, B, C or anything. Or you can use variable is equal to and then input and in between these parentheses you can type the length of the input that you want to give to the computer to, for example. And you are going to use this get string command, then you will have to load stdlib.ring because this command is stored in this file. So there are four ways of getting input. Whichever command you type, the ring program will ask you for the input. So you have to give input, for example, hello. As soon as you type C and then variable, with C command, it will print the input that you have provided to the computer. But remember, as we have typed 2 here, that the length of the input should be 2. But the length of this input here is 5. So when we type C variable, it will only print 2 characters from this input because this length is 2. Now let's try practically. So I have already written certain statements. C, what is your name? First it will print this statement and then it will demand your name, my name, and it will store that input in the variable my name. And then it will print how are you, and then it will concatenate this any name that you provide with this and will ask you how are you, Mr. Something. So let's run it. It has typed as what is your name, provide your name here and hit enter. It will ask you how are you, Roshan. Instead of using give, you can use get and you can use this method as variable is equal to input. Let's use this variable is equal to input. So instead of give, I type variable that is my name is equal to input and then I type the length of the input, that is the Roshan's length is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me type 5 here intentionally and then say what's your name, type your name, hit enter. It will type Rosha, not Roshan, because here you have written 5 in the input, that the length should be 5. How will you write comments in ring program? For comment, you can use this hash sign, double forward slashes, or for multi-line comment, you can use forward slash with asterisk and at the end asterisk and then forward slash. So these two things are used for single line comments and these things are used for multi-line comments. String concatenation. For concatenating two strings together, you can use plus symbol. For example, you are storing these two variables in A, but you want to concatenate them. So A is equal to hello plus world. And then type C A, it will print hello world. What do you use for new line? For new line, you use NL. Or you can also use slash n, but slash n can only be used with print commands, while nl can be used with c, with put, and with print, all of them. So the output of both will be like this, hello and then world on two separate lines. Storing a single value in a container. You just type the variable name and then the sign equal to and then any string. So hello world is a string and we are going to store it in a variable a, b, c, my name or anything else. When you type c variable, the hello world will be printed on the output screen. Similarly, you can store a numeric variable in a container like 56 and then c variable 2, it will be printed on the screen. You can store multiple values in a container, for example, in these ways, like variable 3 is equal to, and then multiple values should be enclosed in these brackets 1, 2, 3. Or you can also use colon signs instead of commas. So variable is equal to 1, colon 3. So when you print this variable 3 on the screen, it will be printed like this 1, 2, 3, but in vertical manner, not in horizontal way. This is called the list. You can also store character variables in a container or a mix of them. Let's create a variable called A and store some values in it. And then C A. Run this and these numbers will be printed like this. So how will you get a value out of a list? For example, third value or fourth value. Let's suppose we have a container called A and we have stored numbers from 11 to 15 in that container. And we want the third number from the variable A. So just C, A and in brackets type 3. This means that you are getting out the third value from this A. Remember, Ring doesn't care about capitalization of anything. You can type small a or capital A, it will mean the same. So A and A are identical in Ring program. As soon as you hit enter, it will print 13 on the screen because the third value in this list is 13. How will you add more values to the lists? For example, you have a list called list list and you have stored values from 1 to 5 in that list. How will you add more values to that list? There are three ways to add more values to that list. The first method is using add command. Use add and then in parentheses type list, comma, any number that you want to insert into that list. But remember, this number will be added at the end of this list. Similarly, you can use plus command, that is concatenation command, for adding other values to the list. In this method also, this 6 will be added at the end of this list. However, if you want to insert something in the middle of these values, then you will have to use insert command. Insert list, comma, 3. 3 means that after the position 3, that is after this position, at 4th position, it will insert 10 to the list. So if you have used either add command or concatenation command, when you type C list and hit enter, you will see the output like this. For example, you have a list like this and then you want to add to this A number 5. Okay, then again C A. Once 1, 2, 3, this is the output of this first C. This is the output of this second C after adding the 5. Deleting a value from the list. For example, you have a list that contains values from 10 to 15. You want to delete the third value from the list. Then use del command and name of the list and then comma and the index of the value that you want to delete from this list. So the third value will be 12. So 12 will be deleted. When you type C list and hit enter, you will see that the number 12 has been deleted from this list. Find the length of a list. You use len command. It will tell you about the length of the list. So the length of this list is 10 because it contains 10 values from 1 to 10. You must use C before len. Sorting a list. For example, you have a list that is unsorted and you want to sort it in ascending order. Then type sort A and then print the list with C command. You will see that in ascending order. Now, how to reverse the order of that list? You have a list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you want them to be reversed, that is from 5 to 1. Then type reverse A, and when you type CA, the output will be like this in descending order. Now let's come towards the simple mathematics. To add two numbers together, you use plus symbol. To subtract one value from the other, you use the dash, that is minus sign. For multiplication, you use asterisk. For division, you use forward slash. For modulus, you use percent. If you type C6++, it means that you are increasing the value by 1. So it will add 1 to this value and will print 7 on the screen. And if you use double minus, it will mean that you are decreasing the number by 1. That would mean 5. Some advanced mathematics. For example, you want to find the cos of some angle. Then you just type C cos of that angle, sine theta, tangent, natural log of 100, log 10 of 100. And for example, you want to find the square root of 16, SQRT. And for the power, there is 4 raised to the power 2. That is 4 fours are 16 will be the output of this function. Now let's come towards comparison operators. For example, you have stored a value 5 in a container A and 6 in a container B. And now you want to compare A with B. So just type C, A is equal to B. It means that I am comparing A with B whether the values of both of them are equal or not. Here, the ring program is different from other languages because in other languages like R program or Python, you use double equal to here. But here in ring program, you use only single equal to sign. So A is equal to B and the output will also not be the true or false. The output will be 0 and 1. As you can see that A is not equal to B, that's why it is false, and instead of false, it will print out 0 on the screen. A is greater than B, as you can see A is not greater than B, then it is false, so it will print 0. Now it will print 1, that is it is true because A is less than B. Not is equal to, smaller than equal to, greater than equal to. For storing values in a variable, you use equal signs. For example, you want to store 5 in A, then A is equal to 5. When you type CA, it will print 5 on the screen because you have stored value 5 in the A and now you want to print that A on the screen with C command. You can also use plus equal to sign, but here this is different from this one because it will add 4 to the A and then again it will store in A. So when you type CA, it will print 9 on the screen because A has already the value 5 and you are adding 4 and then storing it the new value in the variable A. So it will become 9. A minus equal to 3 means that A's value, which is 9 now, you are subtracting 3 from that value and then storing the new value in A. So CA will result in 6 because 9 minus 3 will become 6. And then you are multiplying this 6, that is A, which is equal to 6 now. And you are multiplying it with 2 and you are storing that value, the new value, to A again. And when you print A, the result will be 12 because 6 twos become 12. And when you divide this 12, that is A, by 2, the new value will be 6. Now, logical operators. For example, you have two values, A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 6. And you have two conditions. One condition is that A is equal to 5. And the other condition is that A is greater than 3. And in between these two, you use this logical operator AND. And you want that if both the conditions are true, the output will be true, that is 1. And if one of the condition is false, the output will be false, that is 0. As we can see that both these conditions are true, that's why the output is true, because A is equal to 5 and A is also greater than 3. Instead of typing AND, you can use double ampersand signs. This is another example. A is equal to B, which we can see that A is not equal to B, and A is greater than B. As this condition is false, that's why it will result in 0 output. That is the false output, because both the conditions are not true. Another logical operator is R. R means that when both of these conditions are false, the result will be 0. And when either of these two conditions is true, the output will be 1, that is true. So in this case, A is equal to B, this is false. And A is less than B is true. So one condition is true among these two, that's why the output will be true. You can also use these signs instead of R, which are called pipes. So two pipes also means R. The not statement. Not statement reverses the answer of this condition. If we had typed A is equal to B, it would result into 0 because this condition is false because A is not equal to B. When you type not in front of this, it means that you are reversing the condition, that if it is true, then print out false. If it is false, print out true. As you can see, this is false and we have typed not in front of it, so this will become true and will print 1 on the screen. Instead of not, you can also type this exclamation sign also. Now let's come towards conditional statements, if else statements. For example, you have a variable a 5 and another variable b whose value is 3. So to type if conditions, you will have to type if and then the condition. That is, for example, a is greater than b, this is a condition. Then you have to type these two curly braces, just like you type in R program or most of the languages. So you have typed these things after the condition. Another thing, the parentheses. You can use parentheses around this condition or you can leave this without parentheses. It will make no difference. So it's a very flexible language. And then you type C, A is greater. If this condition is true, then print on the screen A is greater. And if this condition is true, that is the reverse of that condition, A is less than B, then print on screen A is smaller. And if neither of these conditions is true, then with else statement, we print on screen that A is equal to B. So these are three things, if, and else. Let me tell you about the flexibility now. You can remove these curly braces. Instead of curly braces, you can type at the end, the end command. There is another thing. If you do not use AND, you can also use OK at the end of if statements. And let me tell you another thing. This is just like the if statements of other programs. You can use this if statement from here to here and you can leave these portions just like you do in other programming languages like in Python or R or C language. You can only type this if statement and leaving the rest. You can also type if statements from here to this else if statement and leaving this else statement. Now let's try this in Ring program. Suppose you have A 5, B is equal to 3, and you type if A is greater than B, then C high, and else if A is smaller than B, then print by, and in case of else, then C nigh, and at the end, you enclose this with this thing. Now run this by clicking on this button, you will see high. Why the output is high? Because the first condition is true. That is, A is greater than B. Okay, now let's remove these things and type end at the end of this if statement. And let's now change this as well so that we can see the output whether it is changing or not. Now click on this and you can see it has changed to 9 because now this condition has become false and this condition has become true. So no, because now this condition is also okay, sorry, we have typed both of these conditions identical. Let me change this condition to this and now run it again. You can see it has changed to buy because now this condition has become true and this is false. You can type okay instead of end. And now let's change this to equal sign. Run it and now the output is 9 because this condition is false, this condition is false. So both of these conditions is false, then this will be our output. Now let's study the switch statements. For example, you have variable a and you have stored a value in this variable 5. The method of switch statements is that you have to type switch first and then the name of that variable, that is a, and then you use these curly braces. Inside these curly braces, you type case 1, c a is 1. It means that if the value of a, that is if that is the case that a is equal to 1, then you should print a is 1. If the value of a is equal to 2, that is this is the case, then print a is 2. And if the value of a is 3, then print a is 3. Else c a is greater than 3. So when all of these conditions are false, then this statement will be printed on the screen. Now let's come towards the flexibility of the switch statements. You can remove these curly braces. Instead of these curly braces, you can type end at the end of this switch statement. It will also work. And another flexibility is that you can remove this end and can type off. This switch statement is very, very flexible. Instead of typing this, else you can type other. Instead of typing case, you can type on. Instead of this case, you can also type on. So you can replace all of these cases with on, or you can replace some of those cases with on. So all of these will work. Now let's try that switch statements. For example, you have a variable a which is equal to 5. So switch statements, switch, switch the value of a, and then you type this thing. When case is 1, see hi. When case is 5, see hello. And when else, see nothing. And then at the end, enclose the curly brace. Okay, now hit this button and you will see hello, because the case is 5. The value of a is equal to 5. Let's change the value of a to 6. Now this statement will be printed here, because neither of these conditions are true. Nothing is printed here. Now let's remove these curly braces, and instead of these curly braces, we write off statement here. Again, it will work. Now let's change this to 2 to 1 and hit enter. It will print hi, because a is equal to 1, which is this case. So see hi. Now instead of off, you can type end here. Also change the value so that we can see the difference in the output here. As you can see, now the output has changed to hello. Now let's change this case to on. Now let's change it to 6, and now it will print nothing, because neither of these two conditions are true. You can change this to on, you can change this else to other. So it's very flexible. Now let's come towards the while loop. For example, you have a variable and you have stored 1 in that variable. How will you write while loop in ring program? You just have to type while, and then you have to type the condition, that is a is less than 10. For example, you are telling the ring program that until a is less than 10, you have to run this loop until this condition becomes false. This while statement tells R that you have to run the loop again and again unless this condition becomes false. Then after this, you have to type these curly braces, and inside these curly braces, you type C, A. This is one of the statement that you are telling ring that you have to print the value of A and then increase the value of A by 1. So A is equal to A plus 1. As the value of A is 1, the 1 will be added and its value will become 2. And in the next loop, its value will become 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this condition will become false, and the loop will stop printing A on the screen. Now let me tell you about the flexibility in this while state. You can remove these curly braces, and instead of these curly braces, you can type end in the as the last command of the while loop. For example, a's value is 1, and then you type while a is less than 10, and use this, see the value of a, that, and then a is equal to a plus 1, and then enclose this with curly braces and run this. You will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. As soon as it becomes 10, the loop stops. You can also use put instead of c. Remove these things, and instead of these curly braces, let's type end here and change this value so that we can see the difference here. Now it has written the values till 11. What if you want to print these values on new lines? You just have to type plus and L, which means new line. So just hit enter and all the values will be printed on new lines. Now let's see how do we write for loop in ring program. For for loop, you type for I is a variable which is equal to 1 to 20, and then you start curly braces and ends curly braces. Inside these braces, you type ci. It means that we have a variable I and it has values from 1 to 20, and we are printing all those values one by one on the screen. The flexibility here is that you can remove those curly braces, and instead of those curly braces, you can type next at the end of the for loop. Or you can even remove that next and use end at the end of the for loop. Let me tell you about another flexibility here. You can use another optional command step in front of this condition, and in front of step, you can type numbers of jumps. Step 2 means that it will jump to the second number and will leave one number in between. So it will print 1 first, and then it will leave 2 and will print 3, and then it will leave 4 and will print 5, and so on. If you, instead of 2, you type 3 here in the step, then it will print 1, and then it will leave 2 and 3 and will print 4, and then it will leave 5 and 6 and will print 7, and so on. Another flexibility here is that instead of I is equal to 1 to 20, you can use I in 1 colon 20. The result will be the same as of the previous for loop. Now let's do a for loop practically. For I in 1 to 10, then this CI, and then enclose it in curly brackets and run this command. All the numbers will be printed here. Just type plus new line here and all the numbers will come to the new line. You can remove these curly braces, and instead of curly braces you can write next here, and the result will be the same again. And here, instead of n 1 to 10, you can use I is equal to 4 to 9, and then print. The result will be like this now. Okay, do again loop. 10 has been stored in container A, and you want to use do again loop, then type 2 and type C, the value of A, and then A is equal to A plus 1, and type again the condition, that is A is less than or equal to 20. What is the logic of do again loop? The logic is that this will first print the value of A, that is 10, and then it will add 1 to the 10, which will become 11, and then it will check this condition whether it is true or false. If this condition is true, the loop will run again, because the value of 10 will become 11 and 11 is less than 20, so the condition is true. That's why it will run again and will print the value of A, that is 11, and will add 1 to the 11 and it will become 12, and it will go on increasing until 19. Once it becomes 19, it will print 19 and then will add 1 to that 19, and it A will become 20. And when it checks the condition that A is equal to 20, because this condition is also true because we have typed equal symbol here, so this will run again and will print the value of 20 on the screen. But after printing the value of 20, it will add 1 to the 20 and it will become 21. When it checks this condition, 21 is less than or equal to 20, this condition will become false and the loop will stop running. For example, you have A which is equal to 1, and then you type do C A is equal to A plus 1, and the condition is A is less than 12. So let's see. Okay, it will print until 11 because 11 is less than 12 and it will not print 12. Exiting loops. In ring program, exiting means breaking the loop. For example, you have a loop for I in 1 to 10 and C I. If I is equal to 7, then you use exit. It means that it will go on printing the values of I. As soon as the value of I becomes 7, that is this condition becomes true, the loop will stop printing the values of I. Exit command is equal to the breaks command of other languages, that is Python and R. And this OK represents the end of if statement, and this next represents the end of this for loop. Now let's try. For I in 1 to 10, if I is equal to 7, then exit the loop, and OK ends the if statement, and see the value of I, and then end the for loop here. Now let's run. It will not print all the values from 1 to 10. As soon as this becomes 7, it will stop printing the value of I. Okay, it has printed until 6. It will stop at 6 because when the value of I becomes 7, it will not print because C command is after this if condition. Now jumping to the next loop, starting from the beginning of the loop. It means ignoring some value. So for example, you have a loop like this. Here, this loop statement means that whenever this condition becomes true, you have to ignore the value of I at that place and start the loop from the beginning again. So this will print the value of I, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and when the value of I becomes 5, it will not print that value 5 on the screen. It will jump to the next loop, that is 6, and then it will print 6. The loop command is equal to the continue command or the next command of the other languages like Python and R. For example, instead of exit, I type loop here. Now it will not print 7 on the screen, but it will print all the other numbers on the screen. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it has ignored the value of 7 because this condition is true here, and it will jump to the next loop. So 8, 9, and 10. So user defined functions. How will you define functions in Ring program? Remember, in Ring program you always call the functions before defining them. For example, we are going to define the function with the name volume, which calculates the volume of some object for us. The arguments of that functions are length, width, and height. So before defining that function, you will have to call that function. To call that function, you have to use C command and then the name of the function and then the arguments of the function. So this will print 24 on the screen. But as this function doesn't exist in our Ring program, you will have to define that function after these statements. You use func for defining functions, and then the name of the function, that is volume, and then the arguments of the functions. You do not need to use those parentheses here, so L, W, height, etc. And then you also do not need those curly braces here, neither you need any colon signs like in Python. And then you find the volume, that is length into width into height, and then you print the vol on the screen. Here in Ring program, the function doesn't need anything at the end. If you leave this without any ending command like end statement, this will be fine. However, if you want something like curly braces, you can add, and even you can use end statement at the end of this function command. Instead of using this func, you can also type def. It will also define function volume with these three arguments. First, let's call the function with three arguments, and then let's define the function volume with length, width, and height, and then use these things and calculate the volume, length into width into height, and then print the value of the vol on the screen, and now enclose this with curly braces. It will calculate the value of 24. You can remove these curly braces. Change this 4 to something 2 so that we can see the difference in the answer. Run it again, it will work. And if you use end at this place, it will again work. Let me change this value to 2 so that we can see the difference. So 8. So all of these forms of functions will work. It means that Ring program is very, very flexible. Okay, if you have functions stored in a file, how will you use them? And how will you define functions and will store in a file? So first, open your Windows Notepad, type in there a function, that is the volume function. Okay, once you write these two statements in your notepad, then save it with the name something like roshan.ring. But remember, after the dot, that is the extension, must be ring. After that, open your Ring notepad and type load roshan.ring. Remember, this roshan.ring must be in the directory which is the default directory of Ring notepad from where it reads its files. After loading, you can use the function vol, which is found in this file, which was defined in this file and was saved here, and now we are calling that function after loading that file. The result will be printed on the screen. I have forgotten one thing here. You must use C before this vol, because without C or without put command or without print command, this 24 will not be printed on the screen. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Bye.